I have here a rear tail light from a BMW X5 E70. This unit, this light is removed from a BMW E70 from 2011 or something like that. It's a LCA model, a facelift, with the LED rear lights. This was replaced because the LED won't work. And the replacement of this unit, I didn't film it because it's something very, very simple. The light have only 3 nuts to remove. After that, you can remove the light from the car, the rear light. You will need to clean the car, grease the area where the seal will make contact, mount back the light, put back the nuts, align the light with the body, and this is all. This rear light seems to be somehow in a good condition. I have here a small crack, but I don't think water have managed to enter inside of the light through this crack, because I don't see any mark here of water on the base of the light. I can see only a couple of dead flies. So I will try to see, I will open it and see what can go bad in this type of light. Maybe the LEDs will go bad or the driver. And if you want for your car, I will show exactly if it's possible to make a small cut here or here, depending where the driver is situated, to remove the driver. If the driver is bad, repair it, mount it back and glue back the case. But I won't recommend you to do this for a client. If you do it for your car, this is something else, but for a client, I recommend to replace the unit with a brand new one. So first I will try to crack open this light. I'll try to separate the lens from the body. To remove this piece, I have a clip here. This one from here, another one here, and another one here. This is a ornament piece that will cover this gap. The next step, I will try to open the light. Fail. Somehow I have managed to remove this piece, but this here have a big crack and it's missing a piece from here. But even if I was able to remove this lens without cracking it and broken here, this won't go back in the same way, I'm pretty sure. You can see inside here the age dust. This is the difference between a old part. Even if you are polishing the exterior of this lens, the interior still will have this fine dust and will look like an old car. Here I have the inside. This is green, because this is almost yellow, because the yellow bulb with this green lens through this somehow yellow lens, it's more to red, will illuminate a clear yellow light. Next step, I have seen inside here a T20 screw down there. Let me remove this seal. And inside here, I can see the two wires, this red one and this green one. These are the wires for the LED light. Now, if I have removed that screw from here, I hope that all this part will be free. Very colorful plastics, very nice. Okay, this is the reverse light housing. Oh, this is from here. This is for the reverse light. And the LED strips are very simple in this end. I don't have nothing. And in this end, you can see here, are the LEDs. Every single strip have its own LED. The board, it's well connected with the case, with these melted tabs. This one. And this one, and I can move the board. So if you want to repair this light, you need to cut the light something like this. Let me see exactly. I think you need to cut the rear casing of the light in this area, because you'll have access to the board. This one, it's easily removable, and this is the empty housing. Now the most important thing, I need to see what can go bad in this thing, the LEDs or the driver part. The red one is plus and the green one is minus. You can see here on this board, I have a capacitor, two diodes, D1 and D2, one resistor, and one controller, the U1. So now I need to see what can fail here, what can go wrong. But from the mark of the board, I think the controller is bad. You can see the color of the board, it's in this area. Now I will use my power supply, 13.2 volts, it's perfect. And now I have said that the green one is the minus, in my case is the black one here, and the red one is the plus, is the red one. And the LEDs are off. Okay, my next step is to see on this board how the LEDs are connected. So from what I see, the LEDs are in series. Oh, they are on. What? I didn't. It's a bad solder. Oh, disappointing. Because I wanted to find something burn inside here. but I will show you in a second. Okay, I will power on my video microscope. With a better light. Oh, it's too big. Let me search for something smaller. Where is it? Here. You can see it. You can see it now. It's moving. This is a cold soldering joint. Let me go farther and let me see here. So this one is the plus, the wire connecting is going here in this capacitor. This is the ground. Next, in this diode, it's between the ground and the plus. This is here for protecting this circuit against the reverse polarity. The name of this diode is the stupid protection. Okay, it's a stupid protection because if someone will power up this module in reverse polarity, this diode will short itself and will blow out the fuse, or the module will enter in protection mode. So I have told you this is the plus. From here will go in this diode. This is the entering of this diode and this is the exit, and from this diode will go in this controller, and this is the supply for this controller, and from here this is the ground of the controller, of course, and this from here is the plus for the LEDs. From this LED will go into this to the last one. And this one from here, it's a ground. And the voltage that will exit from this voltage regulator will be shorted to the ground between this resistor. It's not shorted, but this here is for the voltage control over the temperature. Nice. So in this case, if I will resolder that joint, you have seen it, I have touched it, the LEDs will work. Now I will clean this board. I have used some solvent to do this. Now we can see I have done the connections. These here are together on this side, and this side the same, I think. No, this side are separate. Something like that. It's a little bit moved, but this is perfect. Now, let's see if this is working. Again. Ground and plus. Yes, it's working perfectly. Let's see what voltage we have across the LEDs. Here I'll connect the ground like so, and we need to have 30.1 volts, correct? And here are the first LED, 8 volts. 8 volts for 4 LEDs, that means every LED will have 2 volts. Let me see. 2.1 volts, exactly. So no matter the voltage at the input of the LEDs, I think if I have 8 volts or 15 volts, the LEDs will have permanently 2 volts. Now, for repair this light without removing the lens like I did, you need to have access only on this area here. And for this, I need to modify my drawing from here. And you need to cut somewhere something like this. Something like this, not this big one. And the problematic pins, if you remember, was here on this side, and this side it's staying near the exterior case. Now the wires will go back here. This light, I will throw it away. I have do this only to see how this is built and if it's repairable or not. And this will go here, this will go back here, this will go back here, and here I will reconnect the LEDs, and the rear light is back in order. Now, before I will end this video, I will cut this area here to see if I have access or not. To cut the plastic, I think we'll be able to cut it with an oscillating tool. Let me see. It's very easy. Or with this tool. Okay, now I'm able to remove this cap and you can see the parts, but the hole will need to be a little bit bigger. I think we need to be in this area, something like that. Now it's better. You can see, now you have access to work on these parts to remake the connections. The hardest part will be to solder at the other end. You see here, you need to have a very fine soldering tip. And after that, you can put back the cut piece. Glue it together. You can glue it with hot glue, but I recommend to glue it with the soldering gun to melt the plastic, and after that to pour something on top to make it watertight. And also you need to be very careful when you will cut here.
here on this side won't be a very, very big problem unless you will go very, very deep inside and will exit on this side, on this part. And after that will be seen from outside. But in rest, everything seems to be very easy and doable. I repeat, if you want to do this for a customer, I advise you to replace the rear lights with a brand new one. But if you want to do this for your car, you are more than welcome to do it.
And this is also a successful repair, I can say, because it's working, I have repaired it. With this occasion, I have learned something new. I hope you also learned something new from this video and from my work. If you do so, show me by hitting the like button. If you want to see more things like this, consider subscribing and hit the notification bell to be notified the next second that I post content similar like this. Thank you for watching this video, thank you for being with me, and till next time, stay awesome. Bye now.